Hello, and welcome. This is CT5 Holy. Time for good old arena stuff. Our first match is Shinroi's WoW Arena versus Rex's Mid Guardians. It's a team that. It's not on the site, he said he PM'd it to me because his internet was being weird. So, let's get to it. First up, wait, what? I ate one, yeah. All right. So yeah, first off, we have Shinroi's team. WoW Arena. Rogue, the thief. Mage, the squire. Warlock, the oracle. And Shaman the Priest. Hi DW. And hello to everyone else as well. All right, there's probably decent stream delay. Haha. But yeah, Rex made some tweaks to his team, but we'll get to that in a second. So yeah, let's enjoy his team. Alright, Rogue the Thief. Oh yeah, Shinroi, this guy was like 300 JP over the cap. So I got rid of Abandon and swapped Bandage for Chronos Tear to get him down to 3000 JP. Hope it works out. That's fine, DW. Like, things happen and like. Yeah. I mean, I barely update my teams. Okay. So yeah, Rogue, this thief. Items with Quickening and Steelheart. Mostly there for Wax. And yeah. Red Repel Knife, Hidden Knife. Good combo that we know. Curse Ring, Black Costume. All the good stuff. Mage the Squire. Using White Robe and Church to tank a good bit. Kaiser Plate to strengthen elements. Probably ice then. Yeah, ice, nether ice too. All the ice, because that's the only thing that Kaiser Plate boosts that a black magic user would have access to. Squire also knows heal, yell, throw stone, wish, and focus. Do you really want to be a squire? I guess for the shield. But you lose out on so much MA. Like, it's probably better to just. Let's check. Can you do math? Looks like 20 effective MA. And you could easily hit that. This squire would be better as a wizard in terms of damage. I guess squires have more HP. But yeah. So it depends on what you're looking for. Anyways. An effect of 20 MA will still be relevant. Warlock the Oracle. Silent Song, Paralyze, Sleep, Kiyomori, and of course, Masamune. So just. Yeah, just gonna disrupt you. That's all, she's got the status stuff. This one was kinda weird. I don't know. It's alright. Like Flash out White Robe Defense Ring a lot of it covers a lot of elements. Yes, the Timestone is valid, but White Robe covers some. I think this is acceptable. I'm not. I think that's fine. Just draw for Kiyomori and Masamune. Like, Masamune is sure. Kiyomori is fits with assassin. I don't know. It feels weird. I guess we'll see how it plays on the team. The Priest. Raise 2. Cure 3. Esuna, Wall, and Bolt 2. Of course, Mace of Zeus. Lets her. It's the all lightning thing, so. Hence the Bolt 2. So, good, pretty good damage from there. Because Bolt 2 is the one that hits really hard. And that's all about I have to say for Shinchiroi's team. Yeah, really curious to see how this Oracle plays out. Like, it just doesn't feel like a great... It doesn't feel like a great pairing of abilities and stuff. Okay, on to Rex's team, we have Deathbot, the Archer. Archer Adicator, the Archer. Ooh, fast. Celion, the Squire. And Shur, the Time Mage. So it looks like we've got the supporty stuff between the Time Mage and Squire. Let's take a look just to confirm, and then the Archers will smack people around. So the Time Mage has Haste 2, Slow 2, Comet, Sinkhole, Raze, and Asuna. Yeah, going fast. That makes sense. Don't see anything wrong with this. I mean, it comes to mind anyways. Celion the Squire. What does she have? She knows. Focus, Throw Stone, Heal, Raise 2, Asuna, Dia. It's getting pretty fast. Everyone's at least 10 speed on Rex's team and healing staff. Boost Lydia a little bit. Heal self with Magic Ring. Yay, Aro! I liked Ragnarok Online a lot. Sorry to get sidetracked, but that's what Twitch chat is for. Yeah, more supporting stuff. Yeah, like... DN Throw Stone is her offense. Yeah, support is necessary. Archer Adicator. So Ultimus Bow, 12 speed, attack up, is gonna hurt. Cursed Ring would give you the extra point of PA, so you have a very nice even, so you get the hit the breakpoint for attack up. And 16 times 15, that'd be 240 damage pre-Fury, that's pretty good. That's still gonna hit very, very hard, so no one's... Yeah. Sprinchy is being immune to slow, and then I have to deal with fire weakness, that is great. Warpath, you'll hit extra hard as well. This Archer knows Hawk's Eye, Execute, Stigma Magic, and Revive. And the last Archer, Deathbot. Big damage here. 256, pre-Fury. Hawk's Eye, Execute, Hokoton, Tsumazuku. Or whatever that one ninjutsu spell ability. So a little slower, but it still hits very hard. Warpath. Just big, big damage. Good compat all around. Okay, I'm guessing the faith numbers for 100% raised twos. And yeah, Hokoton, that's an interesting one. But I guess it is AoE, 160. Damage speed times WP. I wonder if... Well, there's nothing more consistent than Cover Fire. I guess Cover Fire can sometimes just give you really low damage, but... Yeah, interesting to see Hokoton used. You don't see it used much, so... Alright, so that's the matchup. So these guys going first could be really problematic. Defense rings. So, Time Mage is immune to Bolt 2. This Squire can hit everyone really nicely with the ice element stuff. It feels like Rex's team looks better, at least on my old heuristics of speed and damage and stuff. I don't know, Maps may very well play factor because Shinchiroi's team gets to go second, likely hit Rex's team first. Oh, but the Archers of Range. Ooh. Alright, we'll find out soon enough. Let me get the maps ready. Rex's archers will hit very hard. They'll do a lot. They'll do lots of damage. This is on what, 30 points of damage? That's not gonna matter too much. So we start off with a Hawk's Eye. Get the poison. And get rid of the elemental, possible elemental absorb? No, it's not elemental absorb on that. Ooh, missed. Very lucky. Nice healing staff whack, 125. That's not bad, it's just like a really good cure one. So nothing really happened. Squire is ready to do her ice one stuff, and there's the bolt to follow up. And this is the problem for Rex if they all land. It looks like they will. Whoa-oh! That is what I was worried about. So let's see what happens on a large map. There are raised two users, which helps, but short charge, paralyze, catches the Squire, denies the don't act, lands don't act, denies revival. More damage incoming. Just raise one from the Time Mage, so Chintroy's Squire is ready to just drop it, and they're all closing in. Yikes. Going first is always good. But if you can survive that first blast, then you're in a better spot. It was pretty rough that, well, it didn't matter too much that the Chintroy's Thief dodged that first crossbow shot. Because it was the mages that did all the damage. Round 2, I think we're going to a fun map? Yeah! Graveyard of Airships. Cool. People are doing stuff. It's a little hasty goodness. Oh yeah, cooking is pretty good too. Well, I'm just a little bit tired. Had some trouble flying, so whoa, another guarded. I guess good oh yeah, Sieve and W Eve. These are good Sieve, so. 68% chance, huh? Alright, here comes the stuff. Now Rex unit gets chance to take a turn, lands a big Hawk's Eye. 253 damage. Pretty strong bolt 2 in response. Scar moves up to heal. And here's an Ice 2 follow-up. Time Mage? Sinkhole? That's a sinkhole! And Rex's team is doing much better. On the holy shit! 265 damage whole Koton. Whoa! I did not see that coming. Hey, Chintroy. You missed round one, which was your team dominating Rex's. You're getting wrecked, though, in this round two. And I can't control the ads, I don't think. If I get rid of the ads, I would. Ads suck. It's really lame that happens. Chintroy doing what he can to stay in the game with the paralyze. So he has the Suna, but the Squire's turn was missed. Ooh, raise two lands. So people are back up, but man, those archers do a ton of damage. No MP for the Hawks from the Hawk's Eye one. Seeing some big numbers. 84% paralyze and good damage, but sinkhole once again. Uh-oh, is that another? Oh no, crossbow shot misses. Jeez. That Squire needs to work on that archer needs to work on his aim. Dia poke, just the poke. Paralyzed lands. And to have high raise percentage, the archers do have more faith than usual. Uh oh, curse ring, repel knife, bolt to heal everyone, and Chintroy is very much back in this. Thief goes down promptly, thanks to the archer. Short charge. Ray to the finish. Ray goes off first. Then comes the paralyze. Oh my god, wait, archer gets a turn? Whoa! Dead Oracle, all before the paralyze. I'm pretty sure that Oracle had short charge. Wow. Wow. Alright. Well. Rex, oh, that was good. Damage? Doing critical. Our times in critical, kind of an awkwarder spot. Raise 2 incoming. Also paralyze. Again, high faith targets. It lands. Archer executes Shintroy's squire. Watch the thief. He's at 1. So get up soonish. Raise 1. Donax still being a nuisance for Rex. Good damage. That was a 40 faith target. Oh my god. Or 40 fury targets. They're still doing just shy or over 200 damage each. The sleep, though, catches both archers, and that's really big. The timage has to go for Asuna again. Squire has a chance to stop this all with a nice. Some damage. Oh, she walks in, gets. Walks into the Asuna to get rid of the poison. Ice is still being charged. Double kill. Double kill. Holy crap. Shintroy is definitely coming back. Again, the thief is there. Thief has curse string. Will come back. Rex needs to drop the squire. She's gonna get a turn. Time Mage is going down? Big crit to drop the Oracle. And everyone's back, and I'm just making too many assumptions, a lot of crazy shit happening. Minion calls too early. What? What was that? That looked weird. What did that archer do? Will it miss? Bolt Rush? No. Well, Ice 2 for a lot of damage. Squire survives. Oh! Thanks, Sandcaster. Duh. Really not used to seeing that skill. Raise 2 misses, but it is 3v1. Squire trying to do stuff if... Oh, no, it's over. Rex clutches it out and takes round 2. Shintroy's team made things interesting. But Squire still does a lot of damage. Shintroy's Squire. Yeah, the Oracle and the Squire helped a lot, right? Oracle, with the paralyzes? Slow things down. Good luck with that, Andrew. But yeah, the statuses from Shintroy's Oracle slowed Rex's team down quite a bit, and then gives them time to recover a little bit, have the Squire go on the offensive. No quickening from the thief, just an arrow to the face, and then charges forward for a knife whack. Raise for exactly, it looked like. Big damage. Onto the Oracle. Oh, Raze missed! Whoa! That must have been is really interesting. It's kind of working pretty well to give his guys turns. Ice onto 2 units. 1 squire goes down. Bolt 2 follow up drops the other squire. Thief is in, lands the donut from the repel knife. And it's looking like round 1. Small map. His team couldn't quite get there. Archer's probably gonna go down. Oh boy, Thief is extra fast. Oh, Archer gets a turn. Could be a big redirect. Hawkside drops the Thief. Here's the bolt. 2. White Robe. Keeping the Squire healthy and happy. Raise 1. Brings back 1 Squire. Oracle has Paralyze ready for it. Except they're fast. He gets a turn. Oh my god, Hulk holds on for a lot. Catches 2 units. Drops the Oracle. Holy shit, there's the- that should be a bolt too, to help heal up this priest. There it is, down goes the archer. Time mage, fast time mage, doing so much work. And the squire, right, the squire missing a lot of turns. That hurts a lot, because that squire has raised too. Which would mean to take a couple of actions from Shintroy's team, from Shintroy's units to drop the raised 2 unit. Instead of just one from either the squire or the priest. Oh my god. Raised 2? Time mage has single and was there in time! Because the squire is matched back up. Woo! Yeah, I like the damage, but wow! Rex's speedy units, they're coming just in time with those clutch sinkholes and getting a turn in to move in for like mid-chart or redirects, getting an action in. Wow. Thief is back though at near full HP. That sounded like a death. And just like that, alright, just like that, Shintroy takes it. Woo. Wow. Very exciting match. Very dynamic game. That was great. Alright, next we have Baron's FFC Arena Champions team versus Andrew's Synergy. Baron's side is like a little tribute to the FFT Arena Champions. We have... Whoa. Okay. We have Avalanche the Thief. True Light the Archer. Leaf the Mediator. And Dante the Time Mage. I assume units used that these guys all use. I definitely remember Leaf's Mediator and Avalanche's Thief. Got the nice two swords combo. Yeah, that looks just like it. Good stuff there. The Thief knows Quickening Steel Heart and some items. True Light the Archer knows Arm Aim, Seal Evil, Execute, Stigma Magic, and Revive. The Romanda Gun to poke. Pack up Romanda Gun, okay. It's a little more than a poke. Solid prod. Mediator, status-y, tanky goodness. Blackmail, insult, Murasame, Kiyomori Masamune. Wow, Reflecting, Magitant, and White Rogue. This seems... This seems kind of unnecessary. So much magic defense. But she's certainly not going to die to magic. This works out. And on Dante, the Time Mage. Haste 2, Slow 2, Stop, Cure 2, Raise Issuna. Oh, they're all a nice 10 speed as well. Cool. Alright, so yeah, we got our, you know, supporter unit. Disruptor unit, main annoying damage person, and yeah, secondary poke again, attack of Romanda Gun should be good prod. Okay. On to Andrew's team with Ios the Paladin. I'm guessing he didn't make another last minute change. So we have Ios the Paladin. Osar the Mime. Grig the Mediator. And Aves the Monk. Or Avis. Yeah, well, might as well start off with the Monk. Because DA Monks. Monk knows. Whoa! I say whoa because this Monk knows Kagesogi.
That's really interesting. So yeah, the monk, Spin Fist, Super Magic, Chakra, Revive, Kagesogi. What? Whoa. Whoa. This looks really cool. Let's look at the other units on the team, because maybe that can tell us something else about what's going on. It is a disrupty thing to go with. Interesting, and... I'm not doubting bags' usefulness. They're great for just free stat points, but like, this is really cool. This is really interesting. Seems cool. Okay, Mediator. Blackmail, Insult, Mimic Daravon, Quickening, Steel Heart, Speed, Ruin. Tanky goodness. Get fast. Get statusy. Necronomicon for zombies. Could be fun. The Mime. Throw item. Okay, so. Yeah, just a lot of items. Great. Just move around. Be tanky. Use items. Paladin has a shield render. Goes well with random double shots. Can go well with the mime. Nurse, Transfusion, Iron Will, Re-Race, Asura, Kiyomori, Masamune. These are all really nice with the mime, because Nurse, Iron Will, self-target, of course, Re-Race. Pretty good chance of self-targeting as well, if this Paladin were ever going to critical. Transfusion, free bonus healing from Mime. Asura and Masamune also work really well. Kiyomori could be somewhat awkward, but still pretty good. Nice. Ooh. Cool. Thanks for the input, Andrew. Yeah, this is really interesting. Five move has teleport. He can move around really well and like bag whack. Really get some heavy bag smacks. I have no idea how this is gonna work. So let's just jump in. Map number one, round one, map 58. 'Cause like, what is this? What's happening? Everyone loves Kiyomori. It is worth noting that, but well, the archer isn't gonna hit hard, terribly hard. Both the archer and the thief, they have unavailable attacks, because Ramondagun and Hidden Knife. Percent of 8 is a big number. Oh no, Kagesogi. Wah wah. Uh-oh, friendly fire. Oh, but that's oh maintenance though. No shield breaking. Already kicking in. Poke? Poke? Well, sucks, Jinchuri. Thanks for tuning in though, as best as you could, and hope to see some teams from you. And yeah, take care. See you around. Insult. Nothing. Is that haste two or slow two? I can't tell. Slow two. Oh my god! Thanks to the range, the archer. Wow, like the 8 range is pretty nice, and the archer actually got a wait so he could come back in. Got the double turn, drop the monk. Whoa! Chakras and teleports. Oh, petrify! Petrify! Something the Chakra Band isn't immune to, apparently. Whoa! So that kind of messes with Andrew's synergy. He says GG, Oh, and the stop as well, brutal. Monk goes down, but does have a re-raise. That's what I thought. I'm surprised the Chakra Band didn't guard against Petrify. Bonk. Ah, Necronomicon didn't work. Down goes the Monk. And down goes the Paladin? Well, that'll prompt a nurse from the Paladin. Or not, he just died. And he's got a 4v1. Brutal indeed. Wow. Andrew, I'm guessing the Monk used Kagesogi in testing. And that typical AI madness is rearing its head. And another Petrify just for fun. Very convincing round one from Baron. Let's see what happens in round two. So it's pretty scary going against fast units with unavailable damage, because the units that can do the unavailable damage is like a ticking time bomb, right? They get their turn, they're bound to get it, especially if they're fast, and then they hurt you, and it's unavailable, you can't do anything about it. Have to hope to outlive it, but if they're fast, it's pretty hard. So, we get an early gunshot, some Masamune, Spinny Fist for guarded. Mime had some fun twirling around there. Slow 2 incoming. Yeah, that's weird and good to know that Chakra Band doesn't actually guard from Petrify. It's a little bit more fair now. Master Guide. What happened? It used to be cool. Baron's Thief, not much to do, so just goes for quickening. It's at 12 speed. Truelight's Archer goes for pokes. Kagesogi! No Kagesogi. Weird. I hope I didn't, like, fail the import or something. I probably didn't. I don't know why I would have. Really unfortunate. That's... because assuming the Monk uses Kagesogi reliably, that's a really interesting disruptive unit. It continues poking and poking. High range pokes. He's just all backwhacks, what? So I'm distracted by the fact that the Monk isn't using anything, and that I seem to have like a blister on my foot. Pardon the silence. That looked like a charm happened. Slow 2 is happening. Slows the mime. Archer pokes his friend, knocks his friend back into his senses. I'll serve for a little bit, gets guarded anyway. Now the heals happen to the Paladin. They've continued doing... oh, it's just a Steel Heart battle over there. Now it's going for blackmail this time. Knew that the thief had a, you know, There's a little thing going on between them. I'm using it for blackmail. So everyone's got split up. It's kind of weird. AI doing the status piling thing. And more Steelheart from the thief. Now blackmail this time from the mediator. That's pretty funny. Chronos tier! I'll check to make sure the monk has Kagesogi. Monk has Kagesogi. So I really don't know. Unfortunately... insult happened. And last I checked, the pound is Kyo'd. Yeah, and don't hit it as well. That goes for Megadarvon. And lands asleep. Oh! Good point, Tyrekath. Oh, there's a Kagesogi! Just when we... AI, you're so silly. This is really awkward now that everyone's split up and is sort of doing their own thing. And the archer's not focused. Let's just shoot everything. Masmune. So Baron team going fast. Statuses have been applied. At least the poor paladin. He will die his slow death from the poison. And monk retreats. Sure hope it's because of Don't Act. Mediator very obsessed with the thief. The sleeping thief. So Baron's 3v1 seems a lot more productive than Andrew's 1v1. The mime and monk are very confused, they don't know where to go. Paladin gonna fall down pretty soon. And my goodness, this Steelheart keeps missing. It's probably because he's sleeping. And so now he'll fall down from poison while being completely useless. So too slow is the mime. Oh man. This is really awkward, but yeah, because of the way things split up. Oh, Paladin got so much need HP. He's still in a very sad spot. Thief gets woken up. Counters lands a petrify. Wow. Oh man. Not Andrew's day. Come on, Simon Caster. I think Quickening will stay around in the next patch. I think enough people are annoyed by it that probably not. Like, it's really good, right? It's obviously very good. And... if you're a thief, you probably, or someone with steel, you probably want it. At least if you're boring like me. That's like the whole point of steel. And Steelheart is like a huge, insane bonus. Put herself to sleep. That was funny. I mean, it's hard because so Masamune, it's a big boost right from the haste, big boost of speed right now. Quickening, but it's set at a certain limit. Quickening, in theory, could go out of hand. Could get out of hand if someone were able to use quickening a lot. I know fast units are really good. As we keep mentioning, as I keep pointing out for no reason, we all know it's... I'm just gonna say in the obvious. Oh, wow. Weird that that would happen. Steelheart costing NP. How would that make Steelheart too situational? Steelheart would still be insane. You just... there'd be a limit on how many times you could use it. Learning the form is definitely simpler. And would address a lot of... yeah, lowering the MP, lowering the accuracy is... very simple change that I would be totally fine with. Because 50% base is, like, crazy. Okay, next match is Hero Bulls Beta Toasters 2.0. versus FPK4's None of Your Business. So, both would be too much. Both would be too much. Let me introduce the teams then. This discussion is interesting, so. So, okay, from Hero Bowl, we have Jocasta the Samurai, Terminator the Monk, Ultron the Oracle, and RoboCop the Mediator. Okay, so Mediator, his talk skills, Blackmail, Stall, Death Sentence, Man of Carbon, and items. Probably should just be a chemist with talk skills secondary to get extra supportability. More useful supportability. That's the only thing that stands out. Mithril Gun as extra 2 MA to boost toxic accuracy, though, is pretty neat. Very high accuracy on this Mediator. Whoa, 13 MA. Very high accuracy toxic skills. So keep that in mind as the game plays out. It'd be pretty big. Ultron the Oracle, probably you're going to be your main support unit here. Or another good support unit. Beguile, Dispel Magic, Paralyze, Sleep, Petrify, Cure 3, Raise 2, Shell, Asuna, DS. Shell seems kind of odd. Doesn't make sense because you have the Faith Rod thing. But Flash Hand and White Robe already reduce a lot of elemental damages, and AI plus non-haste buffs. Non-haste and other stuff buffs is weird. But yeah, Faith Rod. So again, very high accuracy statuses here. Interesting. Terminator the Monk? No bag? It's okay. Spin Fist, Repeating Fist, Stigma Magic, Chakra Revive, Quickening, Steel Heart, Steel Accessory. Good stuff. Hey, Quickening. Quickening Monks. And the actual 10 MP from the Earth Glows actually gives the Monk 4 Quickenings without until the Chakra, which is pretty nice. Earth Glows also works really well with the Samurai, because the Samurai knows Kiku, along with Bizenboat, Murasame, Masamune, and Chiri. Nether Fire, Nether Bolt, Nether Ice, Nether Water. Cool. Cool.
Yeah, the nice thing with Samurai, because she has draw out, she doesn't need MP restoration. So the black magic is just good ranged stuff. And then when she's close, she can use her draw out, so she doesn't have MP. She also has Kiku for good range, but. Cool, so that's her level scene. Let's take a look at FPK4s. We have Nun the Geomancer, which I thought I renamed as Non. Oh well. So we have the Geomancer of the Bard, Yor the Thief, and Business the Squire. Oh, it's the Business Squire! The Business Squire. No problem, Sandcaster, just team introductions. We remember this guy. A few drop frames was awkward. Scared of. Okay. The Geomancer. Yeah, Business Squire. Ton of evasion. That's what he's known for. That's what we like about this guy. Squire's heal, wish, death sentence, insult, blackmail. His business is death. I guess blackmail seems fitting somehow. Thief, quickening, steel heart, steel accessory. Chakra, revive, stigma, magic. Stuff you would expect. Lion heart, the extra PA. So hit hard. So that's two hands as well. Cool. Bard is the odd one. So move minus one helps ideally keeps him back for Cheersong. And of course with the summons he still has good range. So he has Cheersong, Moogle, Titan, Fairy, Carbuncle, Bahamut. Cheersong doesn't seem like a great fit, but whatever. If it gives you some speed, it gives you some speed and that's good. And the Geomancer. Raise, Cure 2, Asuna, Holy, and Elementals. And yeah, we haven't seen these teams too many times. Both somewhat older teams, but it should be pretty interesting. Curious to see how the high status percent status work out. It's these guys. Squire will just ignore it all because of his insane evasion, but. Cool! Well, let's get started! Round 1, map 103. Windmill Shed, very small map. Yeah, as Silentcaster said, Quickening, Steelheart, Steel Accessory, like. Yeah, if you want a relevant unit, just put those on someone and, like. Life is good for that unit, because you get quickening, free point of speed, that would just help. Apparently it'd be really helpful. And then Steelheart is 50%+ chance to just wreck someone. More or less, it is so painful having one of your units get charmed. At worst, if they get charmed, like at best, for the victim, they just, like, Asuna themselves, or something. At worst, like, very bad things. As I'm sure you all know. Oh, Meteor goes down really quickly, thanks to Holy plus two-hand Lion Heart smacking combo. Oh, Death Sentence landed from the Business Squire, so. The Samurai's days are numbered. Here's asleep, gets guarded, puts one to sleep, puts the Business Squire to sleep. Did not expect that. Counter death sentence. Well, there's death in somewhere along the way for the Geomancer as well. She gets another holy off for big damage, very big damage, but a little too much damage because the monk gets HP restore. No worries, Andrew. You're doing a lot of good stuff with your teams. Another fire. Ooh, more statuses. Guarded again. Thank you, Aegis Shield. Counter Flood lands the stop. Whoop! Last turn for the Geomancer goes for a lethal holy, except blackmail, 58% chance.
lands. So now Geomancer falls up wild. That's pretty good. It's been a pretty good fight. Obviously the sleep thing is really, really helpful. Oh, big punch! Any follow-up, or is the thief gonna get a turn? Bard has Moogle. Moogle goes off. The meh healing happened. Spinny fists on everyone for not that much. Because that monk had something that... I don't know why. That's weird. What does that monk have? Does that monk have... Does that monk have martial arts? Yeah, throw iron meteor was strange. I thought it should be a chemist, toxic chemist. But I think it might have a little few, at least one extra MA point. Assassins. Oh, there's another death sentence. Oh, big numbers. Woof. Oh no, he doesn't have martial arts, it's just he doesn't have low PA. He went Chakra Band, Earth Clothes, and an accessory that I don't remember. That's why the Sin Fist didn't do so much, but it's doing enough! Here's a Bahamut from the Bard. Reasonable. Okay, yeah. Should be definitely be a Toxic Chemist. Death Sentence doing its... taking its toll. Thief gets his last turn in. Good damage onto the Bard, who now has to run and Moogle. Oh, that's right, no... MP, oh my god, no MP restoration on that Bard. Completely reliant on Chakra. Dragon Rod is fun. It's pretty fun. The thing with Bahamut that I'm kind of mad about it as well is like, it does a really high CC, a really high charge time. So. Two Sword Dragon Rod should be better because you have an extra chance to proc Bahamut. Right, Rod damage will be the same either way, but you have a better chance to get the Bahamut proc. So in the end, it will be more damage. If the unit has high evasion, it's even better to have two swords because you have two chances to whack them anyways. Right? Two chances to hit better than one chance to hit. Ooh, sleep catches two units. Andrew, I don't know. But move MP up, influencing Kagesogi usage. Finger Guard! It's a cheer song, but sleeping units don't get benefit from it? Big punch. That would be an argument. Like, times like that is the reason not to use bags, possibly, but in case of those uneven, weird, uneven terrain things, but generally, extra stat point is really nice for bags. Ooh, counter toggle for quite a bit and get knocked off the haste as well. Kiku gets the kill. Robocop. That high MA mediator. Doing good things. Very rare for it to have missed. I always go back and forth between the match and the Twitch chat, but doesn't look like the meteor has missed many talk skills. Oh boy, cheery. Three enemy units, gets a double kill, friendly fire, totally worth it. Maybe a miss against Finger Guard. we don't see Iga Koga much, Baron, right? When's the last time you saw someone use Iga Koga? Yes, it's a good synergy, but Flash Hat makes it kinda awkward. I know, right, Zioncaster? Okay, Asura for PA, Kiku for range, Kotetsu also for 3 range is interesting. A pseudo 3 range draw out. Also having good AoE. Heaven's Cloud is like the really sad one. Because you can't even use it for, you might not want to use it for Elemental Absorb. If it hits. Because the slow proc.